Now the gold parts have already been primed with bronze. Now to get the first layer, which in this case is old gold. Just a very basic work I'm doing here. Again, just painting on the edge. And the final highlights will be in gold, but here I'm just applying the second shade color. So for example here I won't paint the middle of the Chaos Star, but just the arrows, or the tips of the arrows, so we get a little bit of shade into it. So that should be it in a few seconds for the old gold. Yep. Oh, maybe this one here. The spike. Sup. And the last is, well, guess what? Gold. So I will apply gold just on the most upper part, and that's it. That should be enough. Just a few strokes here and there. This is a very, very easy and quick way. So now I'm painting just the arrow, the tips of the arrow of the Chaos Chaos Star here. It should be enough, and should be also a little bit above the tabletop standard. So now the bones, the skulls, and everything else. Oh, a little bit of that. I will start with beige brown again. This will be just the base color for the skull on his armor and for the horns, because this is a very Khorne warrior. Oh, did I really say that on on video? Well, yeah, okay. What the heck? So, first layer, keep be sure to cover everything on the horns, even the deeper recesses, unless you want, you do want a little bit darker horn. In which case you should, after this step, go on and apply brown ink, followed by beige brown again. Next step, USA 10 Earth. So now I will just slightly dry brush the skull parts. So, even though the color is wet, again, this should work very well. So maybe you want to apply this color just like, let's say, here on the top of the horn, and not start here at the beginning. But whatever you choose, it's your own option. The miniature should be like you want it and not like I say. And the last thing is, what's that? Buff again. So now just one final small stroke like here, flip, done, here, just on the tip, as I said previously, here. So now, this should be it for the horns. And now for the rest. And now some brown parts. For example, for the amulet here. So. Watered the color down a little bit so it can pull in. So just a few little strokes, and be careful not to hit the armor or anything else you've painted previously. So, and also we'll paint the edge of the shield with this color. So. Well, I like this color combination of red and beige. Oops. And if you mess it up, just brush it off quickly before it has any chance to dry. So at this moment you can see the color is really watered down. So just get rid of the excess paint. Oh, for example here, I've messed up on the shield, so I need a little bit of water. And brush gently over the area. So, now again, should I also, okay, maybe a second layer on the shield. Just to have a smooth area. So some repair work again. Yep. Maybe I should also go. I'll go into the shield here. Just like that. So now this should do the job. And finally, yellow ochre, just for the edges or for some highlighting. So here, here and here, just a little stroke here, and maybe on the edge here, over here, yeah. Should be nice. So, one last thing, the amulet itself, which I will, let's say, paint in green. So, First, a deep green. Let's get this on. Just be very careful not to ruin your efforts. Maybe it's warp stone or whatever. Then going on to, let's say, lime green. So, should be enough just for a bare touch of lime green. So I let it get into the deepest recesses of the miniature and soak the rest off with a dry brush. And now the final for that is German yellow. Let's just take just the tip of the brush full of yellow. And dry brush just the edges, nothing more, nothing less. This will combine with the lime green, and that should be more or less the complete warrior. But as you can see here, and for example here and here, I've painted also the rocks, so we'll need some static grass. Now let us finish the job. Herefore we need a little bit white glue. Go over the places where I have painted red over the grass, over the stones. So this will be the places where I will apply static grass or whatever. In this case I will apply whatever. So 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, 4 of them. Let's say this is enough. Okay, number one, whoops, look at this, getting the same color as the guy. Then a little bit brown, maybe. A little bit green. And brown again. So when this is dry, I will cut the excess off. Or, well, let's just do it now. So here I am again. Let's cut a little bit off. This is too much. In my opinion. One, number two, bye bye. Let's restick this on here. Yep. So I want his leg covered on this spot. Come on. Get over it. Yeah, no, I'm not very nice to the miniature now, but it's okay. Doesn't feel anything. It's a Chaos Warrior. He'll get over it. So this is nearly okay. Chuck. Chuck. And I don't mean Norris. So, this should be it. Maybe the green is a little bit too much, but basically Chaos Warrior is done. Yep. Whoops.